Hi, this is Hannah from ElasticPath, and welcome to episode 3 of our Composable Commerce mini-series, where we confront the truth that the world has changed, and you must weave digital throughout your whole commerce strategy if you want to deliver on ambitious growth goals. In this series, we're going to walk you through a step-by-step process to help unshackle from rigid, monolithic commerce platforms with a new approach called Composable Commerce. This modern approach to building and delivering unique digital experiences has been championed and advocated by Gartner and sets you up to keep up with customer needs, outpace the competition, and hit those business targets. In episode 1, Chenille walked you through what Composable Commerce was and the benefits. She even talked to one of our customers, Pella. If you haven't checked that out yet, I suggest that you do before you dig into this video. But if you have, you're probably wondering and thinking how to get started with Composable Commerce at your business. If you're used to a platform solution, or maybe you're net new to e-commerce altogether, this might seem daunting. I get it. When I first heard about Composable Commerce, I wanted to know, how do our customers bring this to life? In this episode, I'm going to walk you through a step-by-step process of architecting your own Composable Commerce framework. But I can't do it alone. And that's why I brought my colleague, Jamie Smith, along today. Jamie has been designing and building diverse e-commerce solutions for clients since 1999, consulting with some of the world's largest brands like Speedo, Johnson & Johnson, and O2. He specializes in helping clients architect solutions to solve their business problems and maximize their return on investment. Welcome to the Composable Commerce mini-series, Jamie.
Hi, Hannah. Nice to be here.
So, if you're tuning in, we're going to share 4 steps that make getting started with Composable Commerce a no-brainer. Jamie, what are those 4 steps?
In order to get started on our Composable Commerce journey, we need to consider these key steps and really look at understanding what the key business problem is and who the target market is for that key business problem. Evaluate the existing internal landscape, very critical when looking at an architecture in the long run. Identify the ideal solution blueprint and the gaps to solving the business problems. And finally, define your Composable Commerce architecture and see what pieces you need in the puzzle to make you successful.
Okay, great. So now we have our roadmap for this chat. But let's break it down for our audience so they can really set this up on their own. If we start at the top, how can the team define their business problem and target market? What should they ask themselves? How should they get started with that first step?
Great question, Hannah. And where to begin? It's easy to say, it depends. And every business is different. However, in my experience, irrespective of industry and trading model, like direct to consumer, business to consumer, etc., there are common ground rules we've got to follow. Firstly, and most importantly, understand the target persona. Who is it we're trying to actually get to? Is it a consumer? Is it a field engineer? Is it a procurer? You know, an example I'll talk about a bit later, is it a nurse in a clinically clean environment? Now, secondly, how do they need to trade with us? And actually, do they need to trade is another interesting question here, because not always is Composable Commerce just about selling. It can be about many other interactive and key touch points. So are we looking at a single purchase, a repeat order? Are we looking at subscription service? Are we looking at inventory replenishment? Or are we looking at a complex booking scenario where maybe I'm a swimmer looking to book a swimming course and part of that booking flow gives me availability and an inventory level and things to go with it? Thirdly, you say, what experiences do those personas need? And that's quite key, because in the Composable Commerce world, we're always talking about the Internet of Things. So is it a traditional web experience if we're looking at a traditional retailer? Is it a kiosk or a mobile device if in store? More importantly, as we look at the diversifying world, is it things like augmented reality, virtual reality, machine learning events? Is it about voice? Is it about interoperation within something like a fully connected vehicle? The last 2 points lead us back down to why do people buy is the first thing. So that persona, when they do buy, why? You know, is it brand affinity? Is it great customer service? Is it a unique offering? Why is that so important? Because as we start to build an understanding of what the business wants to do and how they target, we can really start to drive into the next step, which we talk about shortly, which is about those journeys and the dynamics that go with it. Finally, one of the interesting questions I ask a lot in the composable commerce conundrum is, realistically, are we looking at new markets? So is this something where a business already trades, they already interact with their consumer base, but their problem is speed to market? It could be, there could be cost prohibitors to why they want to do it. So really getting there is key. So really, the key conundrum to finish with is, when these data points all collide, a solid understanding of both the business problem and the pains form. And it forms firstly in our clients' minds, but also in our implementers' minds. But it's not always obvious composable commerce is a core solution. And you've seen that in some of the examples I've given you. A great example, clients I've worked with over the years, and one of our key customer bases we focus on today in Elastic Path, is around medical devices and within the pharmaceutical industry. If you look at a clinically clean environment, you don't always think about selling goods. Now, e-commerce is the last thing on your agenda. However, if I'm an OR nurse looking at what inventory I have available within my OR prep room, and I've got the surgeon saying to me, this operation will take place at this point in time. Do you have everything you need? Do you have the equipment? Do you have all of the sterilizing units? More importantly, do you understand everything you need to help prep the operating theater and also make sure the patient is scheduled? Well, Linda there, and you've heard in the brief overview to start with, we have things like looking around the room, potentially with an augmented reality experience to look at inventory levels. What inventory have I got here that I don't have to touch? Mm-hmm. Booking and scheduling. How do I schedule the patient? And more importantly, align what the patient needs with the hip replacement part, the necessary clinical items that are going to be used in the operating theater, and how they all collide for that single operation, a one hit and gone. But at the core of it, you have transactionality, you have inventory management, you have booking scheduling control, all colliding at that composable commerce heartbeat.
Mm-hmm. Totally makes sense. Really defining the challenge or what we're trying to solve and getting back to the need in that moment and how it affects critical personas. If you're ready to move on to step two of the process for creating your composable commerce architecture, click through to the next piece of episode three, where we talk about evaluating your existing internal landscape, including technology, team, and your communication plan. Hope to see you there.